Good morning. Normally I'd be out there on the deck this morning, but as you can listen, maybe it's raining, and I thank the Lord for the rain. These talks, these devotional times, devotions from my deck, as I've kind of coined them, just came out of time that I just wanted to share and encourage you. My prayer is that it will encourage you to have your own personal devotion times. That really is my heart. I'm just kind of speaking out of the overflow of my heart each morning, and so I'm hoping that this encourages you to have your own personal time. I'm reading through the book of Mark. Man, this morning it was just great, speaking of the seed and the light. And one writer I listened to said that the candle, to be the light, has to be consumed by the flame. Boy, that's what I want to do. I want to be consumed by the flame of the Holy Spirit. But then I try to read a proverb. And there's a proverb for every day, so I pray you would do the same. That's a great place to start. A proverb a day. Line it up with the day on the calendar today, Proverbs 20. And that's what I read, Proverbs 20, what it spoke to my heart. But then I try to read a psalm. Proverb for wisdom, psalm to feed my soul. This morning, I just kind of walking through the psalms, Psalm 95. Talking about worship and encouragement. But then it makes a statement that's very important. I want you to listen closely. Today, if you hear his voice, do not harden your hearts as Meribah, as on the day of Massah in the wilderness, where your fathers tested me and they tried me, though they had seen what I did. So as I begin to research that again, just through my concordance and cross-referencing, those two places were the two places where the children of Israel began to complain that God was not hearing their prayer, and that they were calling out for water, and they were, and he had already led them across the Red Sea, and then another point had provided for them for 40 years. And here they were contending with God, complaining to God, in those two places. And I just thought to myself, Lord, let's put this down right here. Do not harden your hearts as many are doing in the COVID-19. We will be known by this and how we've reacted and how we've responded. There will come a time when people will look back and say, how did we respond in COVID-19? For the children of Israel, when they hit the hard place, they forgot what God had done. They forgot where God had brought them from. And it caused in them frustration, and it caused in them to get angry at God and get angry at Moses and complain, literally complain. And the word that's used in Numbers and in Exodus is they quarreled, they got angry at God. Boy, it's easy to do that during this time. Let's just get honest, get frustrated. But I want to, as I thought about this morning, Lord, I want to be able to say one day, hey, during the COVID, I didn't harden my heart. I listened. I drew in. I wanted to hear what God was doing. So I pray that be true of you. Hey, I don't know what your day's like, but I just want you to know I'm praying for you. Pray you'd be encouraged in your personal time. And hey, let's stay strong. Let's not quarrel with the Lord during these times. Let's really draw in. Let's run to him. Don't run away from him. Don't quarrel with him. We're going to have those moments of frustration, absolutely. But then turn our hearts back to the Lord. And I just pray God will encourage you today. Let's pray together. Father, thank you for this morning. Thank you for time to be able to just to share my heart. As many are beginning their day, I thank you for the rain that we hear. We're grateful, Father, and we just pray you would encourage us today that unlike the children of Israel, we would not harden our heart here in this crisis moment, but we would lean into you, we would trust you, and we would walk accordingly, knowing that you have blessed us in the past, and you'll bless us again. And I pray it in Jesus' name. Amen. That's just a reminder that he's blessed us in the past, he's with us now, he'll be with us into the future. Hey, may the Lord bless you today. Thank you, Marilyn. Stacy, thank you for joining in. Joyce, Eric, God bless y'all. Have a good day in the Lord.